Impeach him. Really? Really? For what? You're going to sue me for doing my job? Okay. I mean, think about that. You're going to use taxpayer money to sue me for doing my job while you don't do your job.
The train bringing refugees through Mexico to the United States breaks down due to overuse and the sheer number of people hanging onto its side seeking a ride to what they believe is freedom. The federal government cash fund for this crisis is running out of money faster than a Kardashian bank account. And now we have armed militias gathering to protect the border in what could turn dangerous at any second. Brace yourself and buckle up. Welcome back to Midpoint, everybody. Currently, let's also welcome a fellow at the Center for Immigration Studies, a former member of the Immigration and Naturalization Service, and former official with the U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement, Dan Cadman, joins us today. Dan, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Dan, there is a couple of things here that are rather alarming. And first of all, I want to get down to what we are hearing and what we're going to talk about later on in the show. Armed militias are now taking up positions around the border at certain places right now. They claim they are there to help law enforcement. Dan, I got to tell you, it's scary because all I can think of is armed individuals, people there, emotions running high. This could be a recipe for real disaster.
I think you've just stolen the phrase that I would have used myself. It is a recipe for disaster. And one of the ways that the federal government can ensure that that doesn't happen is to be sure that they saturate the border areas with an adequate number of Border Patrol agents, ICE agents, deportation officers. And if need be, perhaps it is time to ask National Guardsmen to play an assistive role in the border, as they have in the past in Texas, Arizona, and elsewhere.
Let me then follow up with what they can do now, because you have officials there, you have law enforcement there. What is it that they need to be doing right now in order to bring this under some simple control? Because the people are going to show up no matter what you do.
Well, I'm not sure there are enough Border Patrol agents there right now, or even assigned agents from ICE. A lot of them have gotten wrapped up in the transportation of these individuals on buses, charter aircraft, et cetera, to disperse them throughout the United States. And each of the officers that's involved in that kind of transportation is an officer that's not available to actually be there pursuing his or her main duty of patrolling the border and safeguarding the sovereignty of the United States. So there is a problem there. And the National Guard seems to me one way that they could ameliorate the amount of time and effort that they're spending right now on transportation. Although, frankly, I'm not a big fan of the dispersal of the individuals throughout the United States.
Let's talk a little bit about money here. And I think you touched on that very briefly here, because this is something which I think people are going to be rather interested in, and this had to happen sooner or later. The Homeland Security Agency, responsible for removing immigrants who are in the country illegally, will run out of money by mid-August unless Congress approves the president's request for $3.7 billion. Also, Customs and Border Protection will run out of money by mid-September at what is being called the current burn rate. There are people I've talked to in immigration who say they're surprised it's lasted this long because of the tremendous amount of money they're spending here. Is it not fair to say that this is a group of people that are simply stretched so far that there's very little they can do in actually protecting the border at this time?
They are. And it's a sad irony that one of the things that's happening here that's helping them with some of the effectiveness is that a lot of the people who are being apprehended are being apprehended because they're turning themselves in. That is astounding to me. That is so unusual in the annals of patrolling our borders that it tells you something about the mindset of the individuals who are showing up now. It suggests that they have absolutely no fear whatsoever of removal from the United States.
When it comes to the money that is being spent here, and Dick Morris was just here with us a few moments ago and we talked about this, in this $3.7 billion, there is a tremendous amount of money in there that is earmarked for housing, for lawyers. It would seem to many people, if they look at it, that it is indeed not exactly to return people to other countries, but to keep them here, to make sure that they can find a way to stay here in America. That has got to be very disappointing and distressing to a lot of people who have always fought the battle, if you will, to try and keep the United States safe at the border.
Well, it is disturbing, and it certainly, at least in my opinion, puts the lie to the notion that the border is safer and more secure than ever, which is the line that has been used by the administration and particularly by former DHS Secretary Napolitano. That's clearly not the case. But I would also say that I have a major problem with the idea that the administration is sending out messages to a lot of people who are at risk, who may be juveniles, that it's worth taking that chance of putting themselves into the hands of coyotes, of smugglers who don't really care about them, and not only in the hands of people who are fundamentally amoral or immoral, but also going through some serious badlands of the border areas where they may simply die of thirst, of heat, any number of things. I think the way the administration is doing this is in its own way a cruelty.
Other than simply just, and it can't happen right now, but other than simply just shutting down the border so no one could come across at this point, you've been here, you've been on the ground before, you have seen these things at different levels before. What would be the simple best thing to do at this point to at least start to create some sort of security there, to at least start to bring this under control?
Well, there was a leaked ICE document that got put out on the web that says that 47% of the people coming through are adults. Those people are subject to expedited removal, and so are the children who accompany them. It's only unaccompanied children that are subject to specific rules. So if the government is serious about sending the message back to the other people who are contemplating the journey, then the government should take effective and expeditious action to remove that 47% of adults plus whatever portion of the children are attached to those adults and get them back. That isn't being done.
What would that be? What would that entail right away? Could you detail that? I mean, as far as where do we go?
It seems to me that it could be done quite simply by doing it the way it's always been done at the border in the last decade or two. And that is, if someone is apprehended crossing the border, they're given an opportunity to make a claim to a credible fear for asylum. And if they can't make it, they are ordered removed from the United States. There is no protracted hearing in front of the immigration courts. And they are put on the next plane, train, or bus back to the country from which they emanated. And if that isn't done, then there is no public service announcement that's going to ever be effective enough to tell the others back in the home country, don't try this.
I've got about 90 seconds left here, and I'm sure that you still talk to a lot of your colleagues and a lot of people who work in the Border Patrol, work in ICE. Can you share with us then a couple of things and what you are hearing from them and the basic opinions that they have about the current administration and about the lack of what is being done at the border?
They're deeply frustrated. There is also a certain amount of fear because they have been told repeatedly and without any kind of doubt that if they speak publicly, they run the risk of discipline, of removal. They don't necessarily believe that the administration has enforcement of the immigration laws close to its bosom, and they're deeply concerned about the direction of the country. And I think that's unfortunate in the extreme, that the people charged with enforcing the law have lost confidence in their leaders.
Do you know of anybody who has been fired or anybody who has been reprimanded at this point in INS and the Border Patrol by the government?
No, because most of them have kept their mouths shut, except those who exercise privileges as union officers.
If they were to get out there very quickly, you think the government would fire them in no time?
I absolutely, I do.
All right. Dick, I want to thank you very much, or Dan, I'm sorry, I want to thank you very much for taking a couple of minutes to be with us here, because some of the stories that we're hearing are just sometimes they are unbelievable, and we have to try to put some honesty and some fact to what is happening here with as many as 90,000 unaccompanied minors could be apprehended before the year is out. Dan Cadman, thank you so much for taking the time to join us today.
Thank you.
It is a story that we will continue to cover. It is still a story that is moving. And let me bring that to you right here, because now, according to the Obama administration and others who are looking at this, as many as 90,000 unaccompanied minors could be caught before the end of this fiscal year, September 30th. That is more than a threefold increase over 2013. Take a breath. All right, so you're a millennial and you want a job? Please excuse the dark laughter emanating from economists everywhere. We'll talk about that and a whole lot more when Midpoint Questions Everything, right here on the Newsmax TV network.